Have you ever been sitting at a red light and you revved at an 86 thinking you could easily walk him and he hit you with a and you knew that you'd made a mistake and you had to take an L? You love boost, I love boost, we all love boost, and there's a few different ways of creating boost for your car. So today we're going to talk about turbochargers, we're going to talk about superchargers, we're going to talk about the difference between them, which one is better for your application, and a whole lot more. Alright, to start, let's cover what a Spoolie Boy 9000 is. A turbocharger, better known as just a turbo, is basically a turbine system used to force more air into the engine, because with more air you can add more fuel and ultimately make more power. The turbine pushing air into the engine is driven by a turbine which is powered from exhaust gas, which is a natural byproduct of combustion and is otherwise completely wasted. Back in the old days, a Swiss engineer by the name of Alfred Bucci was like, "What do I name my new invention? A freaking turbo supercharger, man." And so the turbocharger was born. When the turbo supercharger was initially invented, all forms of forced induction were considered superchargers, but today we just call it the turbocharger because superchargers are considered forced induction that are mechanically driven, where the turbo supercharger is driven by exhaust gas, so we just call it a turbocharger. Kind of ironically, the first supercharger used on an internal combustion engine was also done by a Swiss engineer, this one by the name of Gottlieb Daimler, sorry if I butchered your name, who patented the gear-driven pump that forced air into the engine. Although you're probably used to seeing American muscle cars powered by Roots-style superchargers, it was actually a German vehicle that first did it, which came from Mercedes. The models way back then that used superchargers were identified with their compressor badge, and that's actually still a marketing name that Mercedes uses today. Fast forward to the modern day, and you have three different types of superchargers. You have root style superchargers, twin screw superchargers, and centrifugal or centrifugal superchargers. They all use different methods of forcing air into the engine, however they're all mechanically driven. With more air being forced into the engine, more fuel can be added and a larger combustion is created, resulting in more power. Of the three types of superchargers which are currently available, Roots is definitely the oldest design. Inside a Roots blower you'll find two meshing lobes. Depending on the Roots supercharger, these lobes can have different shapes or different amounts of twists. In fact, some of them have no twist at all. If you want more info on superchargers, I definitely recommend watching our other video on it. I'll get it linked up in one of these corners, and it'll also be linked down in the description. That video covers everything you need to know about superchargers. So fundamentally, turbochargers and superchargers do the same thing, which is force more air into the engine, but they do it in completely different ways. With the supercharger, it's mechanically driven, typically by a pulley on the front of the crankshaft along with all the other accessories on your engine, where the turbocharger is powered by a byproduct, which is exhaust gas. Now, regardless of what type of supercharger you're talking about, it takes power to turn it. It takes power away from the engine. Of course, the power it produces is far greater than the power that it pulls from the engine, but it's still worth mentioning because just in the fundamental ways that these systems work, the turbocharger is significantly more efficient since it's powered by a byproduct instead of just taking power from the engine. This brings us to the big advantages of a turbocharger, which is increased power, increased efficiency, and massively improved fuel economy. Relative to the size of them, they're actually really great at improving power. You think about it, the turbocharger is just forcing more air into the engine, so it's effectively making your engine act like a larger engine. To put it simply, a turbocharger is more space efficient than a larger engine of comparable power output. Now, the biggest reason that you'll see turbochargers on many modern production vehicles is for fuel efficiency. Now, there's a handful of reasons that turbochargers increase fuel efficiency, but it mostly comes down to thermal efficiency and how fuel atomizes. In fact, it's pretty common to actually see a 20 to 40% improvement on fuel economy when you bolt a turbocharger to an engine, assuming that it's properly sized and tuned for fuel economy and not some crazy 1,000 horsepower tune. So ha, take that Priuses, all of our death trap project cars are totally fuel efficient. When automakers require more power but want to maintain good fuel economy numbers and emission standards, they almost always turn to turbochargers. This helps them give you a high powered engine without sacrificing other important aspects. It also helps them utilize smaller engines which provide better fuel economy in the first place. Now this brings us to superchargers, where there are actually a lot of benefits even though most manufacturers prefer turbochargers. Now the biggest and most obvious benefit of a supercharger compared to a turbocharger is the fact that there is zero lag and basically no boost threshold. With a turbocharger, you're talking about a turbine that needs to be spinning really, really fast in order to create positive pressure. And that turbine is driven by exhaust gas. So if you're at a low throttle amount, that turbine is not going to be spinning very fast. That means when you open the throttle, when you get on the gas, the turbine needs to go from low RPM to high RPM in order to create boost. This is what's known as boost lag, and the larger the turbocharger, the worse it gets because of the mass that needs to be spinning that needs to go from low RPM to high RPM. This doesn't occur with superchargers because there's no spin-up speed. They're just being driven by a gear or by a pulley. With a supercharger, as soon as you hit the throttle, it's ready to go and it's making boost. There's no lag. And depending on the type of supercharger, there's basically no boost threshold, which means that there's no optimal range. With a turbocharger, you have an optimal set amount of RPMs that it produces the most power in and it's the most efficient. Now with bigger turbochargers, that boost threshold is moved higher up in the RPMs. With a smaller turbocharger, it's lower down in the RPMs. But with a supercharger, that's not really the case. It doesn't exactly have a threshold. Now, centrifugal superchargers are a little bit different because they increase in boost as RPM increases, so they kind of have a threshold, but not really, because it's just linearly increasing rather than having an area where it's most efficient. The biggest downside to a supercharger is that it takes power away from the engine. It takes power to make power. To produce engine power, it needs energy. Because it runs off the crankshaft or a belt, you have to power your air pump with another air pump. That's why people looking for efficiency will typically offer a turbo system instead. It's also why automakers worried about fuel efficiency shy away from installing superchargers. Now, because the supercharger is running from the engine, you also have to worry about mechanical reliability at a higher rate. That's because of the wear that you put on the engine and because you have more moving parts that need to work. Overall, it's going to affect the longevity of the engine. Now, to put it simply, with a supercharger, you have an entire other system on the front of the crank that's being powered by the front of the crank. That's a lot of harmonics that are being introduced to the crank pulley. What's common to see is high mileage engines that have superchargers on them have a significantly more crank bearing wear than a turbocharger of comparable power output, comparable engine size at comparable engine miles. Now, this is because of all the introduced harmonics when you add a supercharger as compared to a turbocharger, which is not adding any harmonics to the crank. Now that we've kind of examined these two and kind of understand them a little bit better, let's compare them head on, where they both make more power, they both add air to the engine, where you can add more fuel and have a larger combustion. The supercharger is going to deliver more power at a faster rate while traveling at lower RPMs. The supercharger is also simpler to maintain and install because it's typically an all-in-one system, but it tends to use more fuel, is more expensive, and is much louder than a turbocharger. If you were to look at the other side of the spectrum, a turbocharged engine won't increase power output until you hit boost threshold, where the turbocharger is spinning fast enough to create positive air pressure. There's also turbo lag, as you have to wait for the turbocharger to spool up to speed. With that said, turbochargers are fuel efficient and very quiet. They reuse the exhaust gas that would normally otherwise be wasted. For most of you in my age group, millennials, a lot of us preferred turbocharged engines over supercharged engines, and honestly, I couldn't tell you why that is, other than the fact that a lot of 90s and early 2000s JDM cars were turbocharged rather than supercharged, and those are the cars that most of us could afford when we were first getting into cars. Now, as far as which one is actually better, it totally depends on your application. There's no clear way of saying which one is definitively better. Although you could argue that turbochargers are better in almost every instance other than drag racing. If you need a ton of torque, linear power delivery, zero boost lag, and you don't care about efficiency, then a supercharger is probably going to be the better solution. And the reason that is popular for drag racing is because there's no boost threshold and there's no boost lag, which means for bracket racing, it is much easier to have a predictable time on the drag stick. If you need a lot of peak power and a lot of efficiency, then a turbocharger is probably going to be the better option. Now, if we were just talking about pure efficiency, which is what most production cars are focused on, then a turbocharger is better in almost every single way, which is why I said that a turbocharger, for most of us, since we're not, you know, building dedicated track cars, a turbocharger is going to be better. We're gonna have more efficiency and basically more power and more reliability. I wanna know what you guys think though. If you were building your own engine for your own dream car, would you rather that engine be supercharged or would you rather be turbocharged? Let me know down in the comments and tell me why. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up because it really helps me out, helps get this video in front of more people. While you're down there hitting the thumbs up button, be sure to get subscribed and check out the other videos that we have on the channel. We've talked about dozens of different other engines and fundamentals and a lot of cool stuff, and I'll see you guys in the next one.